Hello everyone, Amy R here with Prairie Paper and Ink, and I couldn't get last week's color throwdown challenge out of my head. I already posted a video using the colors, but I wanted to make a second one, even though the challenge, as of posting this video, the challenge will be over and we'll be starting a new one early Wednesday morning. But it's kind of fun sometimes. Certain color combos just stick with a person, or they do me anyway. And I wanted to use the Simon Says Stamp Ornate Leaves stamp set again. I used this one a few weeks ago, and I will have it linked at the end of this video. But this time I wanted to stamp the leaves just in solid colors. I love the design on them. So I just inked them up with three different Simon Says inks and then stamped them onto some Simon Says ivory cardstock. And then I quickly cut these out, and once I was done with that, I took a piece of green leaf cardstock, and I'm inking it up with that same green ink, which is also green leaf ink, and I'm using the ornate background, which matches the stamp set. It just, I can't help but not use these, the stamp set and this background together, because they coordinate so nicely. I love this background. So I inked it up with the green leaf ink, and then I just pressed my cardstock onto that with my fingers. And then I'm going to run that through my Big Shot machine with the largest of the Simon Says Wonky Stitched Rectangles Dynamics. And then I used the second largest size to die cut some of the ivory cardstock again. And then I'm using my anti-static powder tool on that and on this little scrap of some burnt orange cardstock. And I'm using sentiments from the Remarkable You set. This was a stamp timber exclusive between Simon Says Stamp and Honeybee Stamps. And as of me filming this video, this set is actually still available. All the other sets have sold out, except for I think one other collaboration set. But this one is still available, and I just absolutely love it. So I thought I would use it again, get a little more mileage out of it, of course. And I inked up the two stamps I wanted to use from the set, and I'm stamping them with Simon's clear embossing ink. And then I'm using the antique gold embossing powder. So after I had coated everything with the embossing powder, I'm going to melt it with my heat tool. And this is always my favorite part when the embossing powder starts to melt. It's just like, oh. Even after, you know, 14 years or however long it's been of stamping, I still love heat embossing. There's just something about it. So after I was done that, I'm going to use my little Tim Holtz tonic trimmer here to trim down this orange piece so that it's trimmed very narrowly right around the edges of this. It takes a little fiddling with such a small piece, but that's what I'm really loving this trimmer for, is I'm able to hold these tiny little pieces like this and, you know, get perfect trimmed straight edges. I'm loving it for that. So trim that down. And then I needed to figure out how I was going to place these leaves on my cardstock. And I always forget I have a roll of the Glad Press and Seal cling wrap. I keep a roll of it behind me in my office at all times. And a piece like this, I'll reuse multiple times. This works really well too when you have like many, many stamped images or embellishments that you're trying to lay out a certain way. And it just clings to it. So I pressed it down after I had made my little arrangement, flipped it over, put all of my dimensional adhesive into place, and then I can just press this back onto that ivory cardstock, peel off the press and seal, and it's where I need it to be. So like I said, I love it for that. I also love it when you have like many, many images that you're trying to line up and, you know, you don't want them falling all over the place. It's perfect for that. And I will reuse that piece a whole bunch of times before I ever have to go back into that roll. So after I had done, adhered those leaves into place, I adhered the sentiment as well. And then I want to go on to my card base, which is the same ivory cardstock. And I used my anti-static powder tool again. And then I had lined up another set of words to create another sentiment from that Remarkable You set and stamped it with the clear ink. And then I'm using that same antique gold embossing powder. And I'm going to melt this with my heat tool as well. And I was going to just leave it as is, like just the sentiment, let that stand out. But I had all the stamps and the inks and everything sitting here, and I couldn't resist stamping the leaves again with those same inks on the inside of the card just to kind of give it that little extra something something. Also, I don't think I stamped the word amazing perfectly straight, and it was kind of bugging me. So stamping the leaves in the different colors is a way to kind of distract from that. Rather than restamp it, just stamp some things in color to distract from the obvious. So anyhow, that's one of my hacks. So I just stamped those leaves with those same three Simon Says ink. And I don't know if I mentioned in the beginning, I used the green leaf, burnt orange, and deep purple. So after I had done that, I adhered the ivory die cut piece on top of the green with some foam tape. And then I'm just going to run my ATG adhesive on the back of this green cardstock and adhere it to my card front, and catching it just in time that I didn't adhere it upside down. So press that into place. And then finally, just as a little bit of embellishment, I'm using some more of these Studio Cadia Vintage Fusion sequins that I just used in the last video that I used this color combo with, actually, which is just funny. But I, again, have these still sitting out from that card and wanted to use them. So I laid out a few on my card front here. And then I'm going to adhere those into place with little dabs of multimedia matte adhesive. And just pressing those into place, lifting and pressing into place with my Crystal Katana. And that finished off today's card. So I will have links below the video to my blog post with links to all the supplies used. I'll still link to the color challenge even though this one's closed. But of course you can always use old color challenges when you're feeling stuck. So check that out below the video if you're interested. Thank you all so much for watching. And I will see you all very soon in the next one. Bye.